It's been 2 days since the fatal crash at 37 Tanjung Pagar Road, which killed all 5 men aboard. As you can see behind me, the crash site is boarded up. Business along this stretch has resumed after the Chinese New Year weekend, with restaurants opened for today's lunch crowd. A few passerbys paid their respects in front of the shophouse, including a friend of two of the victims.
My whole persona is down, my person is down, can't sleep well, very heart pain. I feel very sorry that I saw him at an accident. Then sometimes I feel that, how to say, from bottom of my heart, viewers in Facebook, please don't comment nasty comment, show some respect to their family members.
So I came here to pay respect towards the deceased. They're friends of friends, and it is a personal tragedy. I think it is possible for us to show some compassion while also disagree with the reckless behavior of the deceased.
For residents such as Rita Gonzalez, who's lived in Tanjung Pagar for 20 years, drivers flouting the speed limit at night has been an issue of increasing concern.
We hear cars racing along these roads in the wee hours of the night, and it's quite frightening because a lot of our residents, including myself, we get up at night and we hear speeding cars, a growing concern for us because these roads are very curvature in nature with sharp bends.
Investigations are ongoing. According to the police, the 5 men killed in this incident means it's the highest number of people killed in a single traffic accident in the past decade. The crash also brought to light other issues in the Tanjung Pagar stretch, including narrow roads, especially with parallel parking implemented. Fazana, Friday 4, The Straits Times.